So today I thought we'll do another four cylinder video. So I've not done one of these in quite a bit. So let's use a flat 4 or B4 configuration, starting with the bottom end, probably the most important part of the engine, which will consist of a mostly forged and billet steel parts, and the quantity side nuts on plus 15 with VVT on all cams, twin turbos, because that's the way I like to roll with these types of engines. We'll also use my favorite fuel, which is nitromethane for this particular application. Talking a little bit of power goals, hopefully we will make, well, I'm thinking around 3000 horsepower, 3200 horsepower. If we can hit that mark, that would be pretty darn great. As you can see, this thing is already making some good power. Already making over 1000 horsepower. And we also can move this thing to the moon and back, so we'll do 9500 RPM. Our flowchart is telling us our exhaust is being a pain in our rear. 1400 horsepower already. Man, that's good. Let's add some boost, shall we? What I like about flat 4 engines is the sound. Now, if you don't know, Mitsubishi made inline 4 engines, and Subaru, makes a very potent EJ engine. Now, if you talk to any expert about the EJ, they'll tell you stay away. The easiest way I'll say it to you. But EJs are pretty powerful engines. The only problem is if you have to do head gaskets or replace the spark plugs, well, you have to take the engine out. And that's an operation and a half. But anyway, like I said, what I like about these things is the sound. The sound an EJ makes is very unique. And it's almost like you took a Beetle engine, you added overhead cams, made it very big, you make it very powerful, you make this thing have turbos, and it sounds absolutely insane. That's what I like about flat 4 engines. Maybe I'll do an Evo engine in the near future, maybe. Depending on what type of likes these things get and also what comments I get. That would be fantastic, but anyway, getting back to this. 2700 horsepower with a relatively low boost, we're talking 2.9 bar. Which isn't too much, it's not crazy, but I think we can make even more power. Our flowchart is telling us we have header and turban restrictions. Unfortunately, I can't do much about the turban restriction, I can do something about the boost problem. We need a lot of that. We're also going to lower our aeration as we're going up in our aeration. Let's see, let's pull some fuel. That does not help. Let's see, we're gonna run into issues now because this thing is making a crap load of power. So let's see. This is good. Anyway, come on, 3000 horsepower. There we go. Can we get 3.1 with relative ease? Yes, we can. And our pistons are starting to look a little bit red. But it's all good. Power is important. We need a lot of that. Let's see. So if we mess with the air ratio a little more and we add a little more boost, we're getting up there. So 3,200 horsepower. Nice. Let's see if we can get 3,300. Or at least close to it. Let's see if that's possible. I hope it is. Okay, so we can't add more boost without this engine exploding. It's probably a safe time to also say this engine will probably, in its current format, not make it into a chassis. Or as the Australians like to say, a chassis. I would say it's probably not a good idea to put it in a chassis, but yeah. Yeah, it depends on what comment I get on you. Would you love to see this thing make it into a chassis? And if you do, would you, would it be an entertaining video? As for me, I love making videos. So yes, and I took a little bit of a time away from YouTube. I dealt with a little bit of stuff in my personal life, but yeah, I'm back, hopefully. So that's where I'm going to leave this engine, around 3,282 horsepower. I don't want to push it harder because it's making enough power to where we are comfortable, and also it's at 5% reliability, which that's good. In other words, so I'm going to leave it alone. I think. So 3000 is not really possible. But anyways, we're going to do two dyno runs. One looking at this beautiful engine and one looking at the graph. So let's see what this beautiful machine sounds like. Hope it's good. Man, this thing sounds good. Thank you so much for watching. If you stayed to this part of the video, thank you first of all, and second of all, hit that subscribe button because I'm sure you'll love it around it. Anyways guys, that's all from me for today. I'll see you lovely people in the next one. Thank you guys. Bye bye.